Today we are in Finland, in Turku, that's about 150 kilometers from Helsinki, at a company that is specialized in district heating systems, so a lot of welding, pipe welding is going on. And I have the chance to talk to Tony, the welding supervisor of the company, about a project where they used the ABIBUG, the tool for semi-automated pipe welding. So Tony, thanks for having us here. I'm happy that I catch you here because you told me already this 90% of your work is outside. But here we're in the workshop where you prepare everything. So can you tell us a little bit about the project that where you used the bug?
Yeah, we were building a district heating line in Helsinki in a tunnel, roughly about 10 kilometers of pipeline, 5 kilometers of tunnel and something like 400 welds.
400 welds. And this pipe is, what diameter is it?
DN 1000.
1000, okay, and there's water, hot water,
yes,
hot running
water
through.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Okay, so can you give us a little bit background why it was a good idea or why you took the ABIBUG to do that project?
Yeah, that was from the customer. They wanted to automize or semi-automize the welding process in order to get better quality.
Oh, okay, how did it work out? Because I mean, it was the first time for you to use such a system.
Yeah.
Can you give us some information about experience?
A lot of training, of course, because we never have used that kind of automation before, and even the MIG process, it's not the best for us or the one that we use most. But all in all, after the training, it went quite good, and I think the ABIBUG is better than a human.
Yeah, you told me a bug like this, it runs, it does not get tired. So you would underline that automation in pipe welding makes sense because of getting some stress up from the welders. So.
Yeah, of course, yes. And also when you get everything in right place and running all the good, then there's the quality is better and it does it all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, and you told us already like 400 welds. How long was that project running?
It was like 9 months. Or
9 months?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So, and you said it already, it was all under earth. So it was in a tunnel?
Yeah, it was a tunnel roughly 50 meters below surface.
Okay. And while you were, or the welders were using the bug, how were the experiences to handle it? You said, okay, first training, that's for sure. But then, you know, because you were setting it up and stuff like that, do you have any information for us for that as well?
It's quite easy to set up, and compared to the welding, it's much more easier for the welder to just put it in place and then watch while it does.
Yeah. I mean, they have the control panel in their hand, they would adjust things, I think.
Yes, depending on the position of the pipe, they have to do some adjustments and to watch how it does. But it's still lots easier than the welding itself.
Yeah, and so at the end, your team with the bug in that project made the customer, like the city of Helsinki, happy.
Yeah, I think they were pretty happy with the bug.
One thing that I wanted to ask, you know, there's holes in the pipe at the moment. What was that for?
Yeah, these are for the training or for the certification of the welders. We have to make test welds for every welder before they could go to work, so that they can do it.
Okay, so and then this part of the pipe is gonna send somewhere that people look at it, x-ray it, and then you have, like you said, it's 5 holes, 5 welders.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, thank you, Tony, for your time. I think that was a good insight when automation over a pipe welding makes sense under special conditions, let's say, under earth and stuff like that. So thanks for the insights. If you want to have some more information about the ABIBUG, please check out our website. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Thank you, Tony.
Thank you.
Bye.